The Gold Coast has 57 kilometres of coastline, 5 rivers and 260 kilometres of navigable waterways. The Gold Coast is susceptible to flooding. Past flood events have caused moderate to extensive damage to private property, community buildings, bridges and roads. We can't prevent floods, but there are ways we can plan and prepare for them to reduce the impact on property and our community. Let's look at it from a city planner's perspective. A tool used to look at planning for future floods is flood mapping. Our city's flood studies incorporate the latest data, modelling techniques and community flood information. These were undertaken by specialist engineers. Using the flood studies, we assessed flood risk by looking at how deep, fast and far flood water spread, how big a flood would be and how often it is likely to happen. This allowed us to look at flood risks and ways to manage them. We are developing planning responses to help keep you, the people you love, and the places you live safe. These look at how, where, and what types of future development are safest in an area. Kate and Ben are retired and live in a home on one of our city's iconic canals. They have 12 grandchildren. They've never had a deep, fast-running flood, but people in town talk about a huge flood that happened years ago that affected many homes on their canal. A flood like that doesn't happen often, and it's likely even their grandchildren won't see one that big. They've had occasional smaller floods, but their home wasn't damaged. Ben considered hiring someone to build a waterfront extension in his backyard for the family when they visit, but was told enclosed structures must be outside of planning setbacks from the water to protect against floods. Ben decided to build a second story instead. Harry and Lola were hit hard by flooding a few years ago. Before they bought their home, they'd heard it had flooded badly 15 years earlier, but they loved the creek views and never imagined it could be as bad as it was. They were holidaying when the flood hit and their home was badly damaged. They have now rebuilt using flood-resilient building materials and design standards, but know it may flood again. They've prepared a flood plan, but can't add more buildings or change the way their yard slopes because of the risk it would be to themselves, other people, and properties. The Smith brothers own land they plan to build on. They'll need to investigate this in more detail though, as the land can flood and they're not sure how often or severely. Before they can build, they'll need to make sure people or property won't be put at risk or the flood may worse somewhere else. Belle's a farmer and lives with her sister Holly on a property 20 minutes from the coast. There was a massive flood 30 years ago, but that was before their time. They've had smaller floods, but they've put gumboots on and got themselves and their animals to safety. A few of the sheds were waterlogged, but the farmhouse wasn't damaged. Last year, they built an office out back with floors higher than the level the water reached in past floods. Now, let's look at this from your perspective. There are things you can do to plan for floods that keep you and your family safe and create a more resilient community. There is more information on the Managing Floods page, including a link to flood mapping. Stay up to date and informed about managing floods on the Gold Coast. As new technology and data becomes available, we'll continue to improve our flood models and how we plan for flooding. We're committed to protecting the Gold Coast built and natural environment through detailed flood modelling, mapping, planning, mitigation, and managing the stormwater network. To find out more about your flood risks, how you can protect your property and get planning and building tips, visit cityofgoldcoast.com.au/managingfloods.